tickets for tonight's match between the Clipper College Cobras and your Greenville Crusaders. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Dear Lord, thank you for volleyball and for both teams here tonight. I pray that you bless each individual on Paige Gym tonight and allow your name to be glorified. We love you and thank you for your unfailing love and mercy and the amazing life we can live through you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Teams for tonight's match. First, the 2015 men's volleyball team members for Cobras College. Number 2, Jay Fisher. Number 3, Gary Baker. Number 4, Dustin Henry. Number 8, Clinton Parsons. Number 10, LaShawn Alexander. Number 11, Andrew Wilson. Number 14, Aaron Wingles. Number 16, Alexa Jack. Number 20, James Fulton. And now tonight's starters for the Cobras. At middle blocker, number 1, Vivian Woodson. At outside hitter, number 5, Jared Kaiser. At the guard, number 6, Jesse Hay. At middle blocker, number 7, Luke Drew. Also on the board, number 9, Liam Flanagan. At outside hitter, number 12, Luke Hinson. At outside hitter, number 15, Arthur Kibble. And at middle blocker, number 15, next, the 2015 men's volleyball team members for North Carolina University. Number 7, Silas Jenkins. Number 9, Caleb Marvell. Number 10, Martin Knockouts. Number 11, Carlos Suarez. Number 17, Robbie DeBoer. And now your NGU starters for the night. At the Bear Defensive Specialist, the 5'10 freshman from Main City, Florida, number 2, Dustin King. At center, a 6'2 freshman from Orlando, Florida, number 5, Alexander Shinji. And opposite, a 6'3 freshman from St. Augustine, Florida, number 8, Connor Ryan. At middle blocker, opposite, a 6'2 freshman from Papagola, Hawaii, number 13, Luke Mayumu. At middle blocker, a 6'4 freshman from Lawrence, South Carolina, number 14, Jacob Jenkins. At middle blocker, a 6'7 freshman from Mount Vernon, Ohio, number 15, Matthew McMillan. And then opposite outside here, a 6'2 freshman from Alberta, Canada, number 16, Curtis Swistra. The assistant coach for the Crusaders is Luke Marvell. Your head coach is Dr. Fred Battenfield.
Tonight from Hayes Gymnasium, North Greenville men's volleyball team still looking for their first win in program history. They'll get another crack at it tonight, facing the Cobras from Coker, who have come down to Tigerville for some volleyball action. Starters have been introduced, and we are just about ready to get this volleyball game underway.
Coker does come in with an 0-3 record. In fact, they have yet to win a set. North Greenville hasn't fared much better thus far. 0-6 overall. They have only won one set this season. So both teams got to think that this is a must win for both of them. So we'll see which one comes out on top.
It'll certainly be a milestone win for either team.
Yeah, North Greenville looking for the first win in program history with it being their first year. Now, Coker did not have a good season last year either. They finished 8-21, but they do have a new coach this year. So understandable why they've struggled thus far, but we'll see what they can do tonight.
Coker will get the ball first, and they'll serve it in. Number 12, Luke Hansen, is back deep to send it in. Coker on the left, dark blue uniforms with yellow trimmings, North Greenville in their traditional white and red. And we are underway. The lobbing serve, King gets to it, Chinzing, and McManaway right off the bat gets North Greenville a point. That was a 1-2-3. That was a 1-2-3 kill. McManaway gets North Greenville on the board first. Now number 13, that's Valulu. He serves in for North Greenville. Now here comes Coker, blocked, ball goes up. Valulu gets to it. And McManaway again, that one hit the court floor. So far, McManaway 2 for 2. 2 points for North Greenville, they lead 2-0.
Yeah, McManaway by far the tallest player on this North Greenville team.
Now Coker has to go down to get that one. Now they try again. King digs that one up, Shinzing the set. And here comes Connor Ryan, getting the point for North Greenville. Number 8, 6'3 freshman from St. Augustine, Florida. North Greenville very fast opening the first set. They lead 3-0. Valulu again to serve in. And a light tap over, trying to catch North Greenville off guard. King gets to it, and Ryan into the net. Can't get it over. And so now Coker will get on the board. North Greenville still leads 3-1.
Yeah, there wasn't much Connor Ryan could really do there. It was passed to him a little bit behind him, so he did what he could, but just couldn't quite get it over the net.
And now Coker will get to serve it again. Number 7, Luke Groups, and serves it in. And Ryan with the light tap over, and Coker cannot respond. North Greenville will take the point, 4-1. Diving attempt there by number 13, Artur Cabral. Now Ryan, he's back to serve it in. And into the net. There's the first service error of the game for North Greenville. That is a point of emphasis for them, trying to cut down on the errors.
Gee.
Coker gets the ball back. King handles that hot one. Shinzing digs, and here comes McManaway again. Yes, sir, he does. North Greenville now leads 5-2. North Greenville to serve in. McManaway gets it over. Here comes number 5 right in the middle. Jared Geiser gets a point for the Cobras. North Greenville still up 5-3. Now Geiser, he's back. Send it in. Line drive. Valulu steps in front of King. Shinzing the set. Westra trying to get it over. Coker will respond. Light tap over. Westra gets to that one. Here comes Shinzing, and Ryan with a light tap over, blocked but saved and pushed back over by Shinzing, but a net infraction will be called, and Coker will get the point, and they are 1 point away from evening it up at 5-all. Jared Geiser back again to serve. And Valulu wasn't sure if he could get out of the way or not and deflected it, and nobody else moved, and Coker ties it up at 5. So now Geiser back again to serve. And does so. King gets to that one. Here comes Shinzing. And now Westra to Try to get the kill shot. He saves it, though. Here comes Shinting again. He'll give it to Westra again. Second time's a charm. Westra gets North Greenville ahead again by one. And now Shinting, he's back to serve in. Nice line drive right to Coker. Have to keep it in bounds. Got to get it over right into the net. Number 12, Luke Hansen. North Greenville pulls ahead by two.
And the same thing that happened to Ryan just happened to Hansen as well. Just it was passed behind him a bit and once again tried to do what he could with it, but not able to get it over.
Now here comes Coker again. Kill shot deflected off the hands of Valulu and Jenkins. And Luke Hansen that time makes amends. He gets the point for Coker. And they are down one. Now here comes Devion Whetstone to serve. Now Westra can't get the point for North Greenville. And Coker trying their best to keep it in. Luke Hansen making a diving attempt on the North Greenville side.
Yep, I've never seen a player from one side go to the other that far, at least.
That was very interesting. Westra with a lob serve. And again, Coker can't handle it. Number 16, Aleska Bajelic can't keep it in for Coker, and now North Greenville leads by three, 9-6. And here comes Westra. He serves. And a light tap over cannot be held by Shinzing. And that was Hansen again. Coker down 2 points. Now Bajelic is back to serve. Does so. Westra gets to it. Here comes Shinzing to set. And Valulu is stuffed at the net. Luke Group and Luke Hansen combine for the block to send Valulu packing, and Coker draws to within one. Now Bajelic back to serve again. Nice high serve. Westra handles it. Shinzing the set. And number 14, that is Jacob Jenkins for North Greenville, will take that point, and they surge ahead by two. And Jenkins will go back to serve. High serve. Coker, miscommunication. They keep it alive. Now Westra. And Ryan blocked. North Greenville still staying alive. McManaway that time. Here comes Valulu. He's blocked. And the far court side official. Another net infraction going against Coker. And now North Greenville will take a 3-point lead. And here comes Coker. North Greenville reaches over. And again, Coker called for a double hit. And Cobras want a timeout. Talk about things. North Greenville off of back-to-back infractions against the Cobras. North Greenville takes a 4-point lead, 12-8, here on the North Greenville Sports Network. That's the end of the Coker's timeout. North Greenville has a 4-point lead, 12-8. And Jacob Jenkins sends it in, and another service error going out of the back of the court. Number 6, libero for the Cobras. That is Jesse Day. Wisely let that one go. And now Coker to within three. Number 12, Luke Hansen is back to send it in. high by Hansen. Westra gets to it. Shinzing to set. And Ryan with the light tap over, saved by Bajelic. And another light tap over, trying to take advantage from Hansen, is saved by North Greenville. Ryan with the tap lob over. Bajelic to set. And off the hands of McManaway from Hansen. And Coker will once again take that point. Now Coker within two. And Hansen is back to serve. And a diving save made by Valulu. McManaway, he sets. Ryan gets it over in between the block of Arthur Cabral. And North Greenville gets it back out to a three-point advantage. Serve in from North Greenville. Nice use of a decoy. Hot hand by Cabral. And North Greenville is stuffed. So Cabral can't get the kill, but he'll take the block. And now Coker is down two. Luke Group serves in into the net. North Greenville take that, 14-11. They're up by three. And Ryan is back to serve in for the Crusaders. Set. Here comes Day. Now Bajelic to set. And Cabral sends that one right back. Coker within two again. Nice high serve in from Cabral. King goes down to get that one. Shinzing for McManaway. But it's out. Led that one a little too far on the near court side, and Coker down one.
Yeah, nice idea by McManaway. He hit it in the right location, but just ended up out of bounds. If that was a couple of inches closer to him, would have resulted in a point for the Crusaders.
And Cabral, that serve goes way up. Ryan goes back to get it. North Greenville's got to get it over. King does so. Here comes Day, and now Bajelic with a light tap over. North Greenville again saves it. Westra gets it back over. Bajelic to set. And off the deflection, King gets that one. Here comes Shinzing. Westra again for a third time. No doing. Number one to Davion Whetstone. Ties it up at 14 for the Cobras. Cabral back to serve in. Line drive serve. King gets to it. Shinzing to set for McManaway. The ball gets back over the net off the block. And it's sent back over by number 12, Hansen. McManaway uses decoy. Westra, yes, he does get that one in. Right behind Hansen, North Greenville takes a one-point lead. Serve in from McManaway, gets it over. And Bajelic has to get that one. Coker can't keep it in. Number five, Jared Geiser, runs out of the room and into the scorer's table as well. So North Greenville takes a two-point lead. Serve in for North Greenville. Bajelic to set. Number seven into the net. It will get the point to North Greenville. Luke Group can't get it over. And now North Greenville's up 17-14.
Yeah, the Crusaders have looked strong. Coker's helped them out with some unforced errors, but still, good opening set for the Crusaders.
Now it's a battle at the net off the block from Whetstone. He'll try a second time. Valulu again gets it. Shinzing the set for Westra. He's counterblocked. Ryan gets it. Shinzing again, this time for Valulu. Once again blocked. North Greenville still gets to it. And here comes Westra a third time. And they'll finally take the point.
Got a feel for Coker on that point. They worked their rear ends off to keep blocking that ball, and North Greenville ends up with the point. That's got to be frustrating for the Cobras.
And now here comes number 13, Cabral. He gets blocked by North Greenville, and now North Greenville's out to a five-point lead, and Coker will take their second timeout of the first set, down five. We'll take a short break here on the North Greenville Sports
Network.
Before
we go to break, we're looking at viewer locations, and we have two viewers from Brazil, two from Canada, and one from Serbia. So we certainly appreciate everybody joining us. So with that, yeah, we'll take a break and be right back.
North Greenville up with a five-point advantage. They lead at 19-14, and they have the serve in from McManaway. And now here comes number 12, Luke Hansen, again getting a point for the Cobras. The Cobras trying to get a late set rally, only down four.
Yeah, I think Coker's coming out of that timeout frustrated because of, again, going back to that point, how many blocks did they have? Four or five?
At least three. Three that I counted.
Yeah, so we'll see if they can respond.
That serve trims the net. Westra goes down to get it. Come McManaway back. Ryan with the light tap over. Coker gets to that one. Bajelic the set for Hansen. And he's blocked by Sheenzing. And North Greenville takes a five-point lead again, 20-15. Sheenzing, he'll go back to serve it in. Line drive serve into the net. Service arrow will give the Cobras a point, 20-16. Number two, Jay Fisher, he checks into the ball game, and he's back to serve. And that serve goes into the net. So service error for each team negates any possible advantage. And North Greenville will take a five-point lead once again. Westra serves it in. Jellick to set. And Hansen off the hands of Westra, who almost had it brought down in the far side corner. But Luke Hansen almost hit that one 200 miles an hour.
Yeah, great job by him just to get a hand on it, much less almost get it to land in.
21-17, North Greenville's up. Colton Parsons back to serve. Left-handed serve. Shinzing to set. Valulu gets blocked. Coker will take that point. Number seven, that is Luke Group. And Cabral combining for that block to stop North Greenville. Coker with the serve in and out. Just barely, though. From number eight, Parsons. North Greenville's up by four again.
Yeah, just three away from winning just their second set of the year. So this will be a huge start for the Crusaders if they can take this set.
And Suarez for North Greenville gets it over. Jellick to set, and Cabral gets that one to fall. Far side corner, Coker's back within three.
In the last volleyball game that we broadcast, I believe that was their last game, we heard Coach Battenfield say that it was the final couple of points that North Greenville just really struggled to score. So this is at that point. So the question is, can the Crusaders finish, or will they allow Coker to get back in the set? Just three down, so certainly not too late for the Cobras.
Yeah. North Greenville's up 22-19. Coach Battenfield took a timeout. North Greenville uses their first timeout of the set. Coach Battenfield most certainly talking to them about trying to close the set.
Yeah, and unfortunately we don't have a sideline interviewer for today. We hope to incorporate that a lot more in future broadcasts. So we won't have any interviews today, unfortunately, but did get a good glimpse of what goes on in between sets with Coach Battenfield doing interviews between each set in our last broadcast, so certainly excited to get that going for not just volleyball, but basketball as well, maybe even lacrosse.
So we're back. North Greenville comes out of their timeout, 3 points away from trying to take set number one. Number 12, Luke Hansen, junior from Las Vegas, Nevada, is back to send it in. Line drive serve goes right to King. Off the rafter, and McManaway can't get to it. Xinxing slips trying to get back to it as well. So Coker's back within two.
Yeah, and the low ceiling here you think would be a home court advantage for the Crusaders, but it actually haunted them there. So Coker just 2 points down, right back in it.
Hansen serves. Wester gets to it. Xinxing the set. And he gives it to Ryan. Ryan can't get it in on the far court side. And Coker back-to-back points, back within one.
I think Coach Battenfield's got to be frustrated right now. He's seeing the same thing that's plagued the Crusaders all season happen again.
Westra gets that serve from Hansen. Xinxing sets, and Valulu tries to lightly tap it over. Coker keeps it alive. Hansen trims the net. And they will tie it up at 22.
I believe that's 4 points in a row for Coker, and another timeout taken by the Crusaders.
Coach Battenfield not shy about using his timeouts and sets. It's tied up at 22 between North Greenville and Coker here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Coker's tied it up at 22. Number 12, Luke Hansen's back to serve it in. Coker trying to continue this rally and takes set number one. Hansen serves it right into the net, so North Greenville takes a much-needed point there. They're back up by one.
Yeah, that's a huge mistake by Coker. They had all the momentum coming to the end of this set, and that gives a huge break to the Crusaders.
Battle at the net. Net infraction called against McManaway, trying to tap it back to the Cobras, just a little too far over. So tied up at 23. Got to win a set by two in volleyball. See what happens here. Number seven, Luke Group serves it in. Westra gets to it. Xinxing the set. McManaway tries to get the point. He's blocked at the net. Ryan keeps alive. Xinxing once again. Goes to Ryan. Blocked again. King keeps alive. Goes to Valulu. And now Westra will send it back. Trims the net. And Hansen gets to it. Now Coker will retry. Blocked at the net. And North Greenville gets within a point of taking set number one, but they have to win this next point. That was also, that last point was off of Arthur Cabral.
Looks like Dustin King, the server.
He sends it in. Coker gets to it, but Jellick to set. Number five gets blocked at the net. Coker, Whetstone keeps it alive once again. And North Greenville will take set number one. That shot out the near court sideline from Cabral. And North Greenville wins their second set in regular season competition. And going into set number two, they take a one-set lead over the Cobras of Coker. North Greenville will certainly look to continue this momentum in set number two. And meanwhile, Coker will look to rebound and try to even this game back up. North Greenville takes set number one, 25-23, here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Heading into set number two between North Greenville and Coker. North Greenville leading 1-0 over Coker. It'll change ends of the court. North Greenville now on left-hand side. Coker on the right-hand side.
Yeah, Coker still looking for their first set victory of the season. So see if they can respond. They did do a nice job of staying in that set, ended up tying it at 22 before North Greenville ultimately took it.
Now Jacob Jenkins, number 14, is back to serve. We are underway. Jenkins lobs the serve, and McManaway sends it right back after Coker couldn't keep it in their end. North Greenville back takes the lead here in set number two. Jenkins again serving. Day gets to that one, set by Vajelic, and out of the backcourt off of Hansen. It'll give North Greenville 2 points. Jenkins again serves it in. Comes Coker back the other way. Light tap over. Westra to Ryan. McManaway gets it over. Now Coker's back on the counterattack. And that was Cabral. Gets it through every Crusader player and gets Coker on the board. They're down 2-1. Now Coker gets the ball. First time serving here in set. McManaway's blocked. Ryan once again staying alive. McManaway battle at the net. Coker will keep it alive and ultimately take the point. I believe that was Whetstone who finally got it back over for the Cobras.
And a nice job by Coker to take advantage of the Crusaders being out of position there.
And Group sends it in. King goes down to get it. Shinzing to set. Valulu gets it off the blockers. And North Greenville's back out in front by one. Now Valulu, he'll serve it in. Low serve, makes it over. And McManaway gets a point for North Greenville. 4-2. Looked like that might have been a net infraction. Now Valulu again, high serve goes out of the backcourt. And Cockrell let that one go and get back within one. And Cabral, he's back to send it in. And that one's handled by Valulu. Battle at the net, poked back over. Somehow King keeps it alive, and North Greenville's got to get over. Ryan does so. Now Coker's back the other way. And it gets down off of Hansen.
Crusaders didn't agree that it was in, but that's what the official decides. So Coker has evened it up here in set number two.
Cabral back to serve again. King handles that one. Shinzing to set for McManaway, who snuck around the initial blockers and gets a point for North Greenville. That was a really nice developed play. McManaway came all the way from the far side, and Shinzing set that one up beautifully. Now Ryan sends it in. Low serve, trims the net. And North Greenville will take that ace. They're up two.
Sure he didn't mean to make it that close, but I'm sure he'll take it.
Ryan's back to serve again. That one gets over. Hansen. And now Cabral trims the near court side and gets Coker back within one. Now number five for the Cobras, Jared Geiser. He's back to serve. Sends that one in. King handles it. Shinzing to set for Westra. And Day gets to it, and we have whistles blown. And North Greenville takes a point. Now McManaway's back to serve. Day gets to that one. Now here comes Coker. He gets blocked. That was Hansen. But North Greenville a little too close to the net gives the points to the Cobras. Now Coker. Davion Westone sends it in. Shinzing to set for Jenkins. King keeps it. Now Shinzing will set for Westra. Blocked again. North Greenville will take the point. Alexander Shinzing will go back after North Greenville takes a 2-point lead. Line drive serve is sent up into the rafters by Day. Gillett goes back to get it. Cabral gets stuffed at the net, and they will give the point to North Greenville. Archer to Cabral has definitely had the hot hand for Coker tonight, and Westra got enough of that to send it back. North Greenville's up three. Shinzing again, serves it in, and off the side of his hand, that one looked like it went. It did go diagonal across the court, and so the service will give the Cobras a point. They're back within two. Coker with the serve in. King gets it. Shinzing the set. They will send it to Westra. And he trims the backcourt line and gets North Greenville up three. Number 10, LaShawn Alexander, comes in the ball game off the previous substitution timeout. And Wester is back to serve in. And set up into the rafters by number 5, Geyser. Coker has to get to it. And that was number 13. That was Cabral getting blocked at the net. And Day will tap it back over. Westra, Xinzing. He'll go to Martin Alcox. Gets it off the block. Coker recovers. And number 10 sent back. North Greenville takes that point. LaShawn Alexander gets blocked. And North Greenville's up 4. Westra, he'll serve. Day gets that one. Bajelic to set for number 12, Hansen. North Greenville recovers, bounces around the rafters. King puts it up for Alcox again. He gets blocked. Number 10 and 12, Alexander and Hansen. Get Coker back within 3. Number 12, Hansen. Serves it in. King gets it. Xinzing the set. And they will give it to Valulu. Off the hands of Bajelic. Gives North Greenville 12 points up 4. And Jacob Jenkins will return back to serve. Day puts it up. Bajelic to set. We'll give it to Hansen out of the backcourt. Did it hit some North Greenville blockers? Yes, it did up front.
Yeah, just barely there.
Ever so slightly changed directions, and it looks like caught a piece of McManaway's hand. Now number 10, Alexander, serves it in. King to Xinzing, and they will give it to Valulu. Can Coker recover that one? Yes, they can. Can they get it back over? Yes, they can.
Nice job.
McManaway to Xinzing. They'll fake it, and Valulu gets the point for North Greenville. Good job using McManaway as a decoy, and Valulu sent it back home. North Greenville once again up 4. They're up 13-9. And Luca Valulu is back to serve. Lob serve. Jelic. And they will give it to Hansen. Gets it off the blockers. And the official had to get out of the way. And Coker gets it back within 3. Number 13, Arthur Cabral is back to serve for the Cobras. Line drive serve goes into the net. And the service error will give North Greenville 14 to Coker's 10. Serve in from Alcox. Set up by Bajelic and Whetstone. Shot is recovered by King. Valulu is blocked by Whetstone and Aaron Wendels. Coker's back within 3. And Wendels back to serve in for the Cobras. Line drive serve does not get in the far court side. King and Westra let it go. And North Greenville takes a 4-point lead again. McManaway, he'll serve it in. Gets it over and out of the back of the court. Once again, back-to-back service errors for either team. Gets Coker within 3. Whetstone will send it in. Xinzing to set. He'll give it to Westra. Can he get it down? No. And Coker on a short rally gets it within 2.
Quick scoring update in women's basketball. North Greenville leading Converse 39-24 in the first. Actually, that's up to half.
And Xinzing got blocked at the net by Hansen, trying to go for the sneaky tap. And Hansen saw that coming. And Battenfield, Coach Battenfield will take a timeout. North Greenville up by 1 after being up by 4 earlier, 15-14 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville leading Coker by one, 15-14 in men's volleyball. Coker is on a rally halfway through set number two, and they have the ball, and Whetstone will serve it in. Valulu gets that one. Shinzing to Jenkins, who gets behind the Coker defense, and North Greenville takes that point. In terms of set momentum, that is a crucial point. Shinzing back to serve. Put it into play, trims the net. Coker gets it, and light tap over. King saves it, but into the stands it will go. And Coker will take it down one. As Parsons will send it in for the Cobras. King goes down to get that one. Shinzing to set. And Westra blocked to the net. King to Westra. Now Valulu tries to get it in, and he can't do it. And Coker's tied it up at 16. Parsons again. Line drive serve. Westra right at the net. King gets to that one off of number 13, Cabral. And Westra trying to get it down again. And they'll whistle that one dead. Still tied at 16.
Huh. That's interesting.
I guess we'll have a redo.
Yeah.
But Parsons serves it, trims the net. Wester goes down to get it once again into the stands. And Coker will take the lead in set number two. So Coker surging late in set number two. Right as Cabral. Actually, Parsons sends it into the net. Now North Greenville back tied with at seven. And Wester's back to send it in for the Crusaders. Does so. Day gets to it. Majelic to set, and they'll give it to number 12, Hansen, who gets the point off the block of Alcox and Jenkins. And now Coker's back up by one. High serve sent in and out of the back of the court from Coker. That was Hansen. Now Jacob Jenkins, he'll serve it in again for North Greenville. Gets it in. Coker to set. And Cobras will take the point. Arthur Cabral gets it down for Coker. And they're back up by one. Serve in by Coker. King gets that one. Shinzing will set. McManaway trims the net. They'll be called for an infraction. Point Cobras again.
It's been a good response by Coker after losing the first set in a tough manner. Again, still looking for their first set of the season.
Alexander gets it in, and the net gets in the way of Aaron Wendell's. North Greenville gets 19, still down one.
Seen a good matchup, and we sort of predicted that before we went on the air. Both teams have struggled up to this point, so.
Coker trying to get another point. They'll tap it back over. Suarez gets to it. Shinzing to McManaway. Off the hand of Day gets North Greenville tied at 20. And Coker will take a timeout as North Greenville's tied it up at 20 against Coker here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Thank you. North Greenville tied at 20 with Coker. Suarez served, dangerous going out of bounds. Coker gets blocked at the net. But Cabral will get the point for the Cobras. Another infraction going against North Greenville. Coker's back up by one. They got the lead 21-20. Cabral is back to serve in. Good serve. King goes down to get it. Shinzing to set. For Alcox, he gets blocked, and Wester can't bring it back down. And the Cobras are going to take a two-point lead.
And they were trailing for most of this set, but all of a sudden find themselves 3 points away from taking set two and evening up the match at one.
And Cabral back to serve again for a second time. Gets it in. King sends it into the rafters. And gymnasium once again portrays North Greenville.
Yeah.
And Coker takes a three-point lead. Coach Bentfield takes another timeout with Coker leading 23-20 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Coker's leading by three, 23-20, and they have the ball. They'll get it to serve in. Cabral back for yet another serve. King gets that one. Same thing to set. They'll give it to McManaway. Counter blocked, and Coker within set point in set number two.
I think you're going to see this Coker team go crazy if they can end it here. As worth mentioning again, they're still looking at three. This is their fourth game of the season, 0-3. They have not won a set this season, so 1 point away from doing just that.
Cabral, serve, does not get down.
And they were about an inch or two away from having it there. Very close.
And North Greenville hanging on by a thread. They'll send Silas Jenkins back to serve. Steps up, sends it in. Day gets to it. And Westra almost had a point there again. Shinzing will set for Westra. And he gets it down. So North Greenville trying to come back to life and trying to take set number two, win back-to-back sets for the first time since their preseason scrimmages. Silas Jenkins serves in. Day gets it. Would you like to set? He'll give it to number five. Now King. That was Geyser. Now Westra. And a counter sent right back. Shinzing sets for McManaway. Tries to go for the light tap over. Nothing doing. King to Valulu. And Coker's going to take set number two. And they're not only will they win their first set this season, but they will even the set. Set series up in this ball game at one. So we'll go to set number three with the series tied at 1-1, and we will at least be going to four sets here tonight on the North Greenville Sports Network. We'll step away for a short break. Coker wins set number two, 25-22. Set number three between Coker and North Greenville. Set series evened at one apiece. Coker looks to seize the set momentum again. We will at least be headed to four sets tonight. Quick numbers for you. Artur Cabral leading the way in kills for the Cobras with eight, followed by Luke Hansen with seven. On North Greenville's side, Curtis Wester leading the way with nine, followed by Matthew McManaway with five. And Cabral and Bajelic sends it in. Shinzing the set for McManaway. He got the point for North Greenville. Almost thought he missed the ball.
Yeah, landed out of bounds anyway, so.
Coker must have touched it. So North Greenville, once again, that's a third straight set. They've taken point number one. Now Bajelic sets, and they will give it to Cabral. Adding to his kill total tonight, evens it up at one apiece. And Hansen will line drive it to King. Shinzing the set. He will give it to Ryan. And Ryan gets it in. Barely. Just barely on that far court side. It's North Greenville out in front. And Ryan will go back deep to serve. Short serve gets to Hansen. Jellick to set, and Cabral. Only the second time he's been blocked tonight. McManaway sends it back, and North Greenville's up 3-1.
Quick scoring update. North Greenville women's basketball beating Converse 41-31 with 16:08 remaining in the second half.
Ryan once again sends it in. Hansen to Bajelic, and now they will give it to Cabral. Lightly taps it over, North Greenville recovers. Shinzing sets for Valulu, lobs it out of the back of the court. And Coker gets 2 points, down one. And Luke Group sends it in. King to Shinzing, fake to McManaway, gives it to Westra, and Coker will lob it back over. Ryan gets to it, and McManaway finally gets a point for North Greenville off the hands of Group. North Greenville gets back out in front by two. And McManaway, he's back to serve. Into the net, and they'll get a point to Coker. And Artur Cabral serving for the Cobras. Will get an ace near side corner, tie it up at four.
Yeah, Crusaders didn't even move a foot. They thought it was gonna go out, no question, but just lands in there.
Cabral, get another shot. And that one will sail out.
Yeah, that one was nowhere close. But going back to Patrick McManaway, he came in leading the team in service errors with 15, and he is unfortunately has not helped himself out tonight. I think he's had at least three.
And that serve into the net off the hand of Alexander Shinzing will give the Cobras the tie.
Yeah, Shinzing's up there in errors too with 12 coming into the match. So it's plagued North Greenville all season long. We've talked about that several times, even in the exhibitions, but seems like they have improved. So that's a positive note.
And Jacob Jenkins one-handed that right in between some Cobra defenders and gets North Greenville back out in front. And Westra, he'll send it in, but into the net. What it looks like up here, North Greenville just not getting the contact on the ball they want on the initial serve. And Whetstone, he'll send it in. Westra to Shinzing, and they'll give it to Ryan, who gets it off the block of Bajelic and Group. North Greenville takes a point. They lead 7-6. And Jenkins, he'll serve. Lobs it up and out of bounds. Coker will tie it back up at seven. Coach Battenfield take his first time out here, set number three. We're tied at seven between North Greenville and Coker on the North Greenville Sports Network. Tied at seven between North Greenville and Coker here in set number three. Both teams trying to gain a decisive advantage into set number four. And number eight, Colton Parsons, will send it in for the Cobras. Valulu gets to it, chinsing the set. And North Greenville cannot keep it alive at the net, as a double hit is called against North Greenville, and Coker will take the lead. Parsons again serves it in. Valulu gets to that one. Shinzing to McManaway. He gets blocked. King keeps it alive into the rafters, and Shinzing will get it over to Day. And now Coker counterattacks. And Arthur Cabral sends it home and gets the Cobras a two-point advantage.
And that was a great spike by Cabral. It was, he had to hit it a little bit behind him, but was able to get enough on it to get it over and got it to land inside.
And that serve does not get down from group. And so North Greenville down one. And Bajelic comes back in for the Cobras. He'll set. And number 12, Hansen, gets blocked. As balls, last touch by North Greenville. The Cobras up two. And that serve, a little too high, off the hands of Hansen. We'll get North Greenville back within one. Serve in from Ryan. Bajelic to set to number seven. Can they keep it alive? No. Shinzing runs out of room as Luke Group gets the point for the Cobras. And Group sends it in again for the Cobras. King gets to it. Shinzing sets to McManaway and catches the Cobras out of position. North Greenville gets back within one, still trying to get the tying point. Now McManaway sends it in, gets it over. Hansen to Bajelic, and Whetstone hit that one a little too hard, and North Greenville ties it up at 11. McManaway sends it in, and unfortunately gets another service error, and the Cobras back in front by one. Brawl once again will serve. And trims the net. Valulu somehow handles that one. Gets it to Shinzing. Westra pops it back over. And Day gets it back over for the Cobras. Shinzing once again. And Jacob Jenkins ties it up at 12. Shinzing will be back to serve in for the Crusaders. Hansen digs that one up. Now they go to number five, Westra. That was Geyser. And now Rind lobs it out of the back. And Coker will take that point and the lead back. Number 14 coming back in, that is Aaron Wendels. 6'3 freshman out of Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. And Wendels will serve and just barely misses the backcourt line. And North Greenville will take the point on a service error. Service error is not plaguing the Crusaders as bad as before. At the end of set number two, they only had six compared to Coker's nine. Now Coker on the attack, and the lob over by Luke Hansen gets the Cobras back out in front. Whetstone will send it in again for the Cobras, and King will let that one go. Dustin King watches it go out of bounds. And Crusaders back to 14 points apiece. And Suarez sends it in for North Greenville. Bajelic to set. Hansen. No doubt about that kill shot. Coker's back out in front by one, 15-14. Hansen right up there with Cabral and kills tonight. Serve in from Bajelic. King gets to it. Shinzing once again will set, and Valulu cannot get the point off of Coker. Day pops it up. And Cabral will take another kill. And Coker's out in front by two. Oleska Bajelic back to serve in again. Trims the net. King gets to it. Shinzing pops it up. Valulu will get it over. And here comes Coker. Bajelic sets. They'll give it to Hansen. Off the hand of Westra and off the light. And Coker will take the point. Coker now with a three-point lead, trying to win back-to-back sets for the first time this season. And Bajelic to Westra. Shinzing pops it up. Ryan gets it over. Right back to Bajelic. Day will set. Give it to Hansen. He gets blocked. And they will get the point from. And North Greenville will get the point. Matthew McManaway getting the block. North Greenville serves it in. Day. Bajelic to set. And that was Cabral with a light tap over. King punches it over and cannot get it to stay in bounds. And Coker back out in front by three. Luke Hansen back to serve. Gets it over. Westra, diving save. Shinzing the set. Ryan, did he get it off a Coker player? Yes, he did. Number 12, Luke Hansen caught him on the right hand, and North Greenville's back within two. Got to think if Hansen doesn't die for that one, that one's probably going out of bounds. Ryan to serve. Today, now to Bajelic. And Cabral, with a rare miss tonight, gets North Greenville within one. Ryan serving in for North Greenville. Day goes down to get it. Bajelic to set. Now give it to number five. Gets it down, Jared Geyser.
That one right on the line. Let's put Coker back ahead by two.
Luke Roop back to serve.
These have been three really good sets. first two came down to the wire, and it looks like this one will too.
King lost it into the rafters in the stands. And Coker doing what they have to, keeping the lead. They are rolling in set number three. They got a three-point lead, 2017. And Coach Battenfield will take his second timeout in set number three with Coker leading by three, 2017 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Coker leads at 2017, trying to win back-to-back sets. And number seven, Luke Group, sends it in. King gets it, Shinzang to Westra, who gets a point for North Greenville. North Greenville hanging around in set number two, but not able to take the advantage and get the lead back. So now Silas Jenkins will check in. Look to serve. Jenkins pops it up. Day gets to it. Zelik to set. And they will give it to number five, Jared Geiser. Coker once again. Just keeping pace, that's what they got to do. Archer Cabral gets it to King. King saves that one, and Westra pops it over. Once again, Coker is there. Bajelic will give it to Hansen. And it'll depend on if it caught the hands of a North Greenville player. Yes, it did. North Greenville trying their best to block, and Coker take a four-point lead. Number 13, Archer Cabral. Back to serve. Comes a serve in. And that's an ace. Trims the near court sideline. North Greenville starting to look a little confused. Coker will take a 5-point lead.
So Coker had not won a set all season long. All of a sudden, they could be up 2-1.
And Cabral. Now Shinzing and Westra. Did he get the point? Yes, he did, off the block of Bajelic. And North Greenville trying to form some kind of rally. Down four. Give it to Shinzing. He'll serve it in. Nada will give Coker set point for set number three. North Greenville started out very good on serving, and that has deteriorated through the past couple of sets. Geiser's back to serve for the Cobras, and King decides to get it. Shinzing sets for Westra off the block. And Coker will indeed take back-to-back sets, and they will take the set lead 2-1, and they will look to take the whole match in set number four in this match versus the North Greenville University Crusaders. Will step away for this set break. As Coker takes set number three, 25-19, and the set advantage, 2-1 here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
For
Ready for set number four between North Greenville and Coker. Coker leading in sets, 2-1. So we'll go over some numbers really quick. Luke Hansen leads in kills for the Cobras, 12. Closely followed by Arthur Cabral with 11. Meanwhile, on the North Greenville side, Curtis Westra leading that category with 12. McManaway followed by 7. Service errors tonight. Coker still ahead in that category, 14, but North Greenville has closed the gap. They have 12. Those are service errors. And blocking-wise, total team blocks with 8 for Coker and 4 team blocks for North Greenville. So far, Luke Hansen, 15.5 points. Cabral, 14.5 points, with Curtis Westra for North Greenville getting 13.5 points.
Quick basketball update. North Greenville actually has just changed to 71-43 with 4:21 remaining in the second half. So it looks like North Greenville women's basketball with a big win there against Converse.
Just keeping pace in that conference race. That is a Conference Carolinas matchup.
Mm-hmm.
North Greenville battling for that 8th and final playoff spot, as well as trying to improve their playoff positioning.
And meanwhile, here at Hayes Gymnasium, this is a non-conference matchup between North Greenville and Coker. Coker in the South Atlantic Conference. And North Greenville, obviously, in the Conference Carolinas.
And now Luga Valulu will start us off in set number 4. And Coker will get their crack at it. Cabral gets blocked at the net. And for the 4th straight time, North Greenville has taken the first point in the set. But the past 2 times, they have failed to win the set. That was McManaway on the block as well. Valulu back to serve again. Here comes Coker, and that will be Hansen getting his 13th kill on the night. Ball goes sailing out of bounds off of North Greenville, and Coker ties it up at 1, just like the past couple of sets. It'll be number 12, Hansen, he's back to serve. Hansen gets it in. Alcox jumps out of the way as it landed in bounds, and Coker's back in front. Off that ace. Hansen once again back to serve. And into the net. So the serve there will get North Greenville the point and tie it up at 2. Set number 4, Coker can take the match. If this does go to a 5th set, they'll play to 15. Ryan gets it over. Day to number 8. That's Parsons, and that kill dug up by Westra. And Alcox got it back over, and Geyser's there for the Cobras. And Cabral waiting to see if it does get down. Yes, it does. Near side corner, Cabral gets the Cobras a point. Coker with the serve. King gets that one. Shinzing will set it, and McManaway gets blocked, gets it. Now Shinzing. Alcox will put it back, and Coker will look to answer. Parsons sets, and the tap over will be good by Cabral. So give Cabral another point, and the Cobras lead by 2. Both teams here battling for their first win on the season. And a serve. Westra, Shinzing, McManaway's blocked. But they will get Coker for a out-of-bounds antenna violation. And North Greenville gets it back within 1. They get the serve. Now here comes Parsons, and Whetstone is blocked by McManaway, and North Greenville tied up at 4. Alcox sends it in. Hansen gets to it, and Whetstone Tries that one, nothing doing, and they will give Coker the point after they call it dead for a double hit against North Greenville. And Shinzing pleading his case, pointing to his hand.
Yeah, he certainly didn't like that call.
Arthur Cabral, he's back to serve for the Cobras. Send it in. Trims the net. McManaway pops it right back over. Dave will get Parsons, and they will set for number five. That was Geyser. His shot was saved by Alcox. Wester with the punch over. Cabral gets to that one. Now here comes Hansen. Cannot make the court sideline. And North Greenville will take the point, get it back within. Actually, it will tie it up at five. And McManaway back to serve. Put it into play. Day gets to that one. And hard hit out of bounds by Cabral. And North Greenville take the point. 6-5, they lead it. Manaway, short serve. Day cannot get to that one. And North Greenville now finally getting some offensive momentum going. They lead by two.
It's McManaway's, believe that'll be scored as an ace. That's his first ace of the season.
Now here comes Coker. And North Greenville gets a point. See what the call is. Double hit against Coker.
North Greenville with a ton of points all of a sudden. Now Coker taking a timeout.
Coker does take the timeout. North Greenville leads it 8-5 over Coker College here on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville with some good offense in set number four, trying to stave off elimination as they take that point. And they will now lead 9-5. North Greenville has come out firing on all cylinders, and McManaway serves it into the net as soon as I say that. And Coker gets back within three. But it really has been a different Crusader team in set number four. But can they hold on?
Yeah, that's the big question.
Geyser to serve in for the Cobras. Puts it up. Gets it over. Ryan goes down to get it. And a light tap over by Valulu. And he gets the block as well. But they'll give Coker the point. Another violation. Coker closes within two. They'll serve it in, and Alcox gets out of the way. And North Greenville will take that point on a service there. They lead 10-7. Alexander Schemzing will serve it in. Line drive, trims the net. Day gets to it. Michelle to set, and out of bounds on the far court side by Hansen. Will give North Greenville another point. Shinzing again will serve. Day gets that one. Bujelic again. Light tap over by Cabral is saved by North Greenville. And Connor Ryan will get the point for North Greenville. Crusaders now lead 12-7. Still looking for their first win. Shinzing again. Today. Now they'll white tap over by Cabral, but Shinsing's there to get it. King pops it up. Westra off the hand of Cabral. Cabral keeps it alive, and Hanson will pop it over. King once again is there. Shinsing and Ryan deflects off the block and gets the point for North Greenville off of Hanson and Whetstone.
North Greenville starting to run away with this. I believe this is their largest lead of any set.
6 points.
Maybe their largest lead of the entire season.
Shinzing once again serves it in. And Bajelic snuck a ball over and gets a point.
Yeah, great
for
decision.
The Cobras.
Great decision there.
Saw North he had a hole and he took it.
Yeah, North Greenville definitely wasn't expecting it.
And LaShawn Alexander is back to serve it in. Short serve. Dug up by Westra, and Valulu gets it off the block of Hanson and Group. And North Greenville back to a 6-point advantage. If we do go to a fifth set, these two teams will play to 15. Westra serves in. And Brzelek to set. They'll give it to Hanson, who gets stuffed at the net by North Greenville. And Coco will take a timeout. North Greenville with a 7-point advantage, 15-8 here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
As we return, it has gone final. Women's basketball, North Greenville beating Converse 76-52.
It's North Greenville with an offensive surge in the fourth set. They lead 15-8. Westra sends it in, and Coker will get a crack at it with Cabral. And saved by Shinzing. King puts it up for Westra, and Westra right down Main Street gets the point.
Crusaders improve the lead to 8, or excuse me, that's right, 8.
Westra will send it in. Day to Bajelic, and now Hanson. He got blocked by Connor Ryan, and North Greenville, 9-point advantage. It's about been the best set by far all season for Greenville.
Not including the exhibitions.
As Westra's service error goes out of bounds, and Coker gets a point, first one in a long time, it feels like.
Yeah, as soon as the season started for North Greenville, we saw the difference between club teams and official NCAA teams.
Shinzing sets, they'll give it to Ryan, and gets blocked. Combo block of Luke Group and Luke Hanson.
But of course, speaking of NCAA teams, we had to see the Crusaders open up against the best team in the nation, Pepperdine, ranked number one.
And Pepperdine has actually fallen in the NCAA rankings. They have lost a game.
Oh, wow. Did not realize that.
Now Shinzing once again sets. Valulu, underhand tap over, somehow is saved by Coker, but North Greenville ultimately get the point.
Well, at the time, they were number one, so there you go.
Now Valulu will go back to serve it in. Short serve, trims the net. Day goes down to get it. Bajelic to set, and they'll give it to Hanson. Now they'll have to keep it alive, and Cabral tries to get it. Westra saves that one. Shinzing will give it to Alcox, and Alcox bang it home, and North Greenville takes a 9-point lead.
Well, the ball hit the ceiling again, but North Greenville, it had been sort of plaguing them a couple of different times where the ball hit the ceiling and ended up landing on their side, but they were able to adjust and get it over the net for the point.
And Cabral has saved, that shot saved by Alcox. And now Hanson with the tap over. Sheenton comes in, off the rafters again.
And there it goes.
And there it goes, and Coker will get the roof point, 19-11. I believe Pepperdine in the last NCAA men's volleyball rankings was fifth or sixth.
Yeah, we'll have to look that up in just a moment.
Coker with the serve. King to Sheenting. He'll give it to Alcox. And Alcox once again. Martin Alcox coming into this game, certainly pulling the Crusaders away from Coker. They lead it 20-11. And Carlos Suarez will serve. Day gets that one. Vigelic to set. Number five. Geyser blocked at the net, but they'll give Coker the point.
Yeah, it looks like Pepperdine now ranked sixth in the nation. Loyola Chicago, the new number one.
If you notice something, seven of the 15 ranked teams are from the state of California.
Wow.
Coker with the ball. That sir trims the net. King gets it. Shinzing the set. McMahon away. Did he catch the corner? Yes, he did. And Martin Alcox will send it in for North Greenville. Day gets to that one. Bajel accepts. And here comes Cabral. And once again sends that one back home. And Coker closes to within eight. They will need a massive rally to try and win this match. It will come down to a fifth set. It looks like Cabral with the serve. King gets it. Shinzing the set. They'll give it to McMahon away, and he cannot. Actually, he does catch the far court side. Now they give it to Coker. I didn't think that one got in.
Yeah, the flag was raised by the line judge, so I think that was just a mistake by the official. And eventually they got it right.
Coker's within seven. Shinzing will set it. They'll give it to Westra. And Westra catches the near court side. 22-14, North Greenville. Trying to close out the set and take it to a fifth one. And we'll play to 15 to decide this match. Manaway serves it in into the net.
Yeah, this is just the second time that the Crusaders have played in a set four. This is the first time all season that Coker has played in a set four.
Substitutions coming on for Coker. Number two, Jay Fisher. He'll come in.
Jay Fisher, the server for Coker.
5'11 sophomore from Boynton Beach, Florida. And he'll serve it into the net. North Greenville within 2 points of a set point. And Alexander Shinzing will serve in. Put it into play. Fisher, actually that was number five. Those guys are getting that one, and that ball will sail out of bounds and give North Greenville the point. And we have set point here in set number four for North Greenville. Shinzing will serve. Geyser gets it. Bajelic to set, and number 12. That was Hanson, saved by King. And Ryan off the block. Once again, Geyser keeping Coker alive. Day to Cabral. And Ryan again with the tap over. And Coker will take that point. Contact with the near side antenna. Coker staying alive still. North Greenville with some room to give. Set point again. Coker with the serve. King Shinzing will set, and they will give it to Luga Valulu, who will take the fourth set for North Greenville. And we head into the fifth and final set between these two teams. We'll play to 15 to decide this matchup between North Greenville and Coker. We'll step away for a short break. Set number five upcoming between these two schools here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Ready for the fifth and final set, which we're fairly certain will be played to 15 points.
Yeah, we know that's the case for women's, but
I'm pretty sure it's the same yeah, rule in the Olympics.
We haven't seen anything different for the men's. We haven't had to worry about it up to this point in the season, but we do have to worry about it now, so I guess we'll all find out together.
Coker will get the ball first to serve in set number five. And we're underway. Serve trims the net. King goes down to get it. Shinzing will set, and they will give it to Connor Ryan. And for the fifth set in a row, North Greenville takes the first point. Doesn't really mean much, but an impressive stat line.
Yeah, it gives you an instant little advantage. Not much, but just a little bit.
Ryan to serve in. Geyser gets that one. They will give it to Cabral. Ryan with a diving save. And Bajelic to number 10, Alexander. North Greenville saves it again, and Alcox stuffed at the net by Alexander. And number 12, Hansen.
Thank you.
Hansen with the serve. King will give it to Shinzing. Shinzing to set. McManaway off the hand of Day. And North Greenville gets that point. Day gets to that one. Off the serve from Alcox. Bajelic to set. And Cabral stuffed at the net again. McManaway and Westra combined for that block. And North Greenville, once again, seizing some early offensive momentum. They lead 3-1. Alcox again to serve. Bajelic will set at the net, and they will give it to Geiser. Alcox once again gets that one. Shinzing with the putback. No point yet. Day give it to Cabral. Actually make that Hansen, and North Greenville staying alive. Ryan blocked at the net, but North Greenville will take the point as another antenna violation called against Coker.
And we have received word from the scorer's table, as a matter of fact, that this set is indeed played to 15. So we do know that now.
And that saved by King, and Coker blocked at the net. They will get the point to the Cobras. Player went down hard on the floor as Alex Sean Alexander. He will get up under his own power, and he'll go back to serve. North Greenville leads it 4-2. And Alexander, King gets to it. Shinzing fakes McManaway. Restra will be blocked at the net. Hansen once again gets to that one, as well as Group. Alexander back again to serve. King gets to it. Shinzing will fall down setting it, and McManaway catches the far side corner. Gives North Greenville a 5-3 advantage. McManaway serving it in, gets it over, and Coker, slight miscommunication between Geiser and Group, gets North Greenville a 3-point lead. Coker will call a timeout, try and figure out what they're going to do as the set drags on. Crusaders up 6-3 on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville leading 6-3 in set number 5 against Coker. North Greenville looking for the first win in program history. Coker looking for the first win on the season. And Cabral again stuffed at the net. McManaway and Belulu get that block, and North Greenville up 7-3. McManaway again, and another service error will go against him as Coker will get the serve back and only down 3. Cabral, send it in. King gets that one. Shinzing will set it. Valulu gets the point off of Jesse Day. North Greenville up 8-4. And North Greenville takes a timeout. Coach Battenfield making sure his defensive strategy is set. North Greenville will be leading it 8-4 as this set has only played the 15. The North Greenville is off to a quick early lead here on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville 7 points away from getting a win. May be able to hold on. Vigilic will set it. And Hansen blocked at the net, but violation called against North Greenville will give the Cobras a point, down 3-8-5. Number five, Jared Geiser will be back to serve. King gets to it. Shinzing will set, and here comes Westra getting the point. 6 points away. North Greenville up 9-5. Westrell, serve it in. Day gets to it. Pajelic tried to set for group, and he got blocked at the net. Valulu, and Valulu gets that one. 10-5, North Greenville leads it. Westrell will be back to serve again. Lobs it up. Comes Pajelic, he'll set it, give it to Hansen. Light tap over is off the hands of Ryan and Valulu, so Coker gets 6, down 4.
Certainly not too late for the Cobras, but they'll have to get to work very quickly here. Have to score a couple of consecutive points.
They'll start with group. King to Shinzing. They'll give it to Valulu off the block of Alexander, and North Greenville gets to 11, up 5. They will sub in Valulu, or they will sub in Suarez for Valulu. It's now Carlos Suarez, number 11. He'll serve it in. Coker gets to it. Bajelic will set, and Hansen bangs it home down the court sideline, and we're going to see, yes, they will give Coker the point. Took a moment to decide whether it caught the line. It did, and Coker is down 4, 11-7. Vujelic, serve it in. Westra to Shinzing, and McManaway with the pushover. Hansen gets to it, and that will be Alexander trying to get the point, nothing doing, and now Alcox will get it to Hansen. Now the Vujelic, and they will give it to Cabral, and North Greenville can't keep it alive, and so Cabral ends up with the point, and the Cobras starting to rally.
Yeah, two
down three.
It's two consecutive points. That's exactly what they needed. We'll see if they can keep it up.
Timeout, North Greenville. So North Greenville take their second timeout to set number five. North Greenville trying to close out this ball game against Coker. They lead it 11-8 on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville trying to close out this ballgame and seal a milestone win. It would be their first. Trying to get it done against the Cobras of Coker. They lead 11-8, but Coker with momentum and the serve. They're down 3. Number 8, Colton Parsons back to serve. Serves it in. King to Shinzing, and they will give it to Connor Ryan, trying to get the point. Falling attempt by Cabral, who put it up to Alexander, sending it out of the back court. 12-8, North Greenville's up 4. officials taking some time to explain something to the Coker head coach. And now they'll have a deliberation at the scorer's table. Luke Harville telling assistant coach to Fred Battenfield, telling his Crusaders to huddle up and discuss how they will wrap up this match.
You can see both teams huddling up. Just a critical moment here for both teams. Coker cannot afford to give up any points. Crusaders can't afford to let Coker back in it. Because, I mean, we heard it from Dr. Battenfield in the last match that they struggle to finish sets. So we'll see what happens. Should be a very exciting finish.
Silas Jenkins back in. He's been the closer of sorts. Let's see if he can get it done with the serve. Hansen gets to it, and the push, punch over, no good by Alexander, and they'll give it to Westra. Now there's battle at the net. McManaway with the punch back, nothing doing. Day gets to that one for the Cobras, and now Cabral gets back over. Shinzing will give it to McManaway, and off the block of Alexander and Cabral. North Greenville's within two. Silas Jenkins, back to serve. Send it in. Day gets to it. Number eight, that is Parsons Setz. And Coker gets it to go off of the block of McManaway and Shinzing. And so Cobras staying alive, down four. And that is number 12. That is Hansen serving in. Shinzing will set it. McManaway gets the point. And this will be match point on the cusp of history for North Greenville. 14-9, it's match point. Greenville just contain their excitement for one more point. They need to hold on. Alcox will serve it in. Martin Alcox gets it over. Kirk will set it, and they will give it to Cabral, who gets it to go off of Silas Jenkins. Still match point. North Greenville's up four. North Greenville out of timeouts. Coker with one left.
Yeah, and as we're starting to close out, we do appreciate all the compliments on Ustream. We're continuing to improve our broadcast, and we're glad you're enjoying it.
Silas Jenkins, now Shinzing. Give it to Westra. He gets the point! And that's gonna do it. And North Greenville has won their first men's volleyball game in program history against Coker College. Amazing game played by North Greenville. They were down in the fourth set. Coker had a set lead 2-1. They battled back and got a well-deserved victory, it seems like.
Yeah, North Greenville has fought hard all season long. They have played some tough teams, including, like we said earlier, the number one team in the nation for two of those losses. But big win here. You got to start somewhere, and a big win for the Crusaders. Coker, still a first-year head coach for them. I'm sure they'll rebound. It'll take some time to build their program up, but you know they'll get it together. They played tough here tonight.
And so North Greenville will improve to 1-6 in this non-conference matchup against the SAC opponent of Coker. Also, just like to mention that the North Greenville football team is in the South Atlantic Conference, same as Coker in football, that is. So.
And that's, and I don't know, Gray, have you heard anything about whether that the agreement between North Greenville and the South Atlantic Conference has been?
I have not heard anything about that because they were in a scheduling alliance. They were not technically part of the conference.
Right. It was a four-year agreement, and this past season was the last season of that agreement. So that'll be interesting to see what the schedule looks like next season for North Greenville football.
I guess we'll find out what the result of that decision is later this year.
Do want to mention our next broadcast is January 31st, so we get a little bit of a break for once. A doubleheader, basketball doubleheader, both between North Greenville and Pfeiffer University. First game is at 2. Second game, which is the men's game, is at 4. And that'll be the end of our broadcast for January. And then it is a very, very busy February. On to not just volleyball and basketball, but softball, baseball, and lacrosse. So we are certainly very excited about that. And we hope you join us for those broadcasts, and we hope to see you. Actually, Gray's going to go over some final statistics for you.
So far, for the Cobras, Luke Hansen and Arthur Cabral finished the night each with 16 kills. Hansen, 21 total points, and Cabral with 20 and a half points. Also like to mention, Aleska Bajelic, 33 assists on the night, so good job by him. On the Crusader side, Connor Ryan, 10 kills. Matthew McManaway, 13 kills. Curtis Westra, 16 kills. Alexander Schinzing, the setter most of the night, 49 assists in that department. Also like to mention Dustin King, he gets 13 digs. For the Cobras, you've got Cabral, he gets 10 digs, followed by Luke Hansen with 8 digs and Jesse Day with 8 digs. So that will just about do it for us here from Hayes Gymnasium. North Greenville wins a slugfest of a volleyball game in 5 sets. They take the 5th set 15-10. So like Alan mentioned, our next broadcast, basketball doubleheader on the 31st before frantic February starts. So we hope you join. We hope you will join us then for basketball action here at North Greenville. North Greenville wins the first men's volleyball game in program history here on the North Greenville Sports Network.